It's not something I feel like they should have to do.
A Greenfield Junior High parent is not happy her daughter is forced to walk to school every day in such cold weather. Greenfield Central School's policy states anyone who lives less than a mile from their respective building, whether it's the elementary school, the middle school, or high school, are considered to live within the walk zone. So the bus won't pick them up.
Unfortunately, you know, the time that they start school is 8:30, and most places you work are going to start at 8 o'clock. You can't drop your child off any earlier.
Melanie Hughbanks isn't able to drive her daughter to school because of her work schedule and has to make other arrangements so she doesn't have to walk 3/4 of a mile in very cold temperatures.
I pay taxes. That's what the school bus is, you know, supposed to be associated with. So, you know, either give them a bus stop or, you know, don't let them, make them go to school when it's freezing.
Even more frustrating, she watches the bus drive by her house every single morning. Because their subdivision, Copeland Farms, is so large, some students meet the 1 mile distance minimum and others don't.
There's people that are in high school in our complex that the bus comes there to pick them up, and then they have to go by the junior high to get to the actual high school. Why can't they just drop them off, you know, and that be their bus? You know, it doesn't make sense to me at all.
A school spokesperson tells me the transportation department uses a software that calculates the distance between the family's home and the student's respective building. They say this way they are providing safe, efficient, and cost-effective transportation. Stephanie Wade, RTV6.
The superintendent's office says if a parent has any questions regarding their student's safety, they can contact them or the transportation department.